Hello fellow video enthusiasts, welcome back to our YouTube channel. In today's video we will continue our comprehensive guide on working with the color scopes. We covered wave, parade and RGB scopes in the first video of this series. You can find the link to it in the description box and in the upper right corner. Now let's shift our focus to the most recent addition to VSDC's scopes window, the Vectorscope. If you haven't updated to version 8.2 yet, we highly recommend doing so to take advantage of this powerful tool. So let's dive into the world of scopes. Scopes are tools that display color distribution in your footage, helping you identify brightness, darkness, and color imbalances. Today we will focus on the Vectorscope, a type of scope that shows color balance. It consists of a circular diagram with segments representing colors and a radius displaying hue and saturation levels. The radius ranges from 0 to maximum intensity, marked by square brackets at the edges. To see the Vectorscope in action, let's create a red rectangle with 0 saturation. You will notice that it appears at the center of the diagram. Increase in saturation shifts the dot towards the red marker. When it reaches the red square bracket, it means that the color has reached maximum saturation. Adding some green shifts the dot towards yellow. When using the Vectorscope, you can customize its display mode to optimize your color analysis. Choose between Classic Mode, Vector Mode, or Hide the Graticule Vectors to focus solely on the colors. Additionally, you can display Remove Color Borders, Black and White Picture, and activate a Skin Tone Radius line. Now, let's explore using the Vectorscope. When saturation is zero, the dot representing colors appears at the center. As saturation increases, pixels distribute towards their corresponding colors on the diagram. If pixels reach the edge, it means they have reached maximum saturation, and some hues and colors may be lost or distorted in the frame. Now, let's reset the saturation to the initial level and see what other information the Vectorscope can provide. In this example, you can see that the dominant colors in the frame are yellow and green. There are some red, magenta, and cyan colors present. None of the dots touch the square brackets, which means that there are no color losses. Based on this graph, you can use the Color Grading Panel tools and HSL Curves tool to control and adjust the colors in the frame. For example, we can remove the magenta and red hues. Or if we want to create a sunset effect, we can add more red hues and move the pixel cloud closer to the red marker on the Vectorscope. The Vectorscope is also useful for achieving maximum color consistency between two frames. It can indicate which colors are missing or need to be removed from a frame. By comparing the Vectorscope graphs of two frames, we can ensure that they have the highest color similarity. Another useful feature of the Vectorscope is the Skin Tone Radius line. It helps identify and adjust skin tones with precision. For example, if you have a frame with prominent skin tones, like a close-up of someone's face, you can use the Skin Tone Radius line to evaluate the color values of the pixel. To focus on the skin tones, you can create a free shape mask to separate the face from the background. This way, the Vectorscope will only show the hues related to the skin tone. After color correction, you can leave the mask on to apply the correction specifically to the face. With the color grading tools, you can adjust the skin tone hues. The goal is to have the pixels on the graph as close to the skin tone radius line as possible for a natural look. Throughout the color grading process, it's important to monitor the Vectorscope to ensure the skin color dots fall within an acceptable range and have no unwanted color casts. Consistency is key, so apply similar corrections to the other frames or scenes with similar skin tones to maintain color continuity and a pleasing visual aesthetic in your video. That's it for today. We hope that you found this tutorial helpful. Stay tuned for more tips and tutorials. Remember to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Keep creating and have a fantastic day!